Hello everyone. Welcome back to STEM Creative Solutions. Today we have a special package that has just come in. We have a 3D printer here today. This 3D printer is the SV01 3D printer, and it has many amazing features which we'll be showing here today. But right now, let's just unbox it for the first time. It's a really big box. But that means it has a big printer waiting inside. I'm just using my trusty X-Acto knife here to cut it open. Make sure to get every corner when you're opening these things up. You can always forget one, and it's kind of hard to open it. Let me just get the side here. This is actually quite a huge package. We're gonna see all the goodies that are inside here and all the extras it comes with. Okay, here's one side. Starting to see inside. Getting me more excited than I already am. There it is. When I say this is a huge 3D printer, I mean this is a huge 3D printer. The Soval printers, SV01. Let me just put this off to the side. Right here, we get a nice guidebook for all about configuring it and a sales card. I'm just gonna put this off to my desk. In the foam, we have a lot of Soval goodies, really tightly packaged, which is great, meaning it's able to survive the post. Let's start with what's in this brown box. We have in here, let me open it up, the power supply. And a bunch of tools, some zip ties, screwdrivers, transfer cables, a lot of good extras. Let me leave this off to the side. I'll put this back in. Next, let me just bring this down. We have just got to remove the layers. This is tightly packaged. You really have to fight with it. 3D printing filament. This is PLA. We're going to have to test to see how quality this PLA is. But so far, I'd say it looks like a quality PLA. 200 grams, so it's pretty light, and it's a pretty decent amount to get you started. I actually bought a second filament just in case. But with the starter filament, you should be able to get a good number of prints. Time to remove some of these styrofoam blocks. Really padded and protected. Let me just leave these off to the side. Last part we got in the top before we move it down to the next layer, like it's Tetris. I'm gonna have to really fight with this one to get out. Let me just... This one's tight in there. Okay, luckily we got it out. This, I don't exactly know what this is now. I'm thinking it's, oh wait, I know what this is. This is the display for the Soval printer. Use this to configure all of your settings. Let me put this off to the side. And that's all we have on the top layer, some filament, some goodies in the cardboard box. So now let's move on to the next layer. Gotta remove this. I think there's 3 layers in total, if I'm not wrong. Here, sorry for the noise, we have the 3D printer bed and body. This one, I'm going to have to pause for a second here because I need to find a place to put this down. I'll be right back. First of all, you need to open the Raspberry Pi imager. And the Raspberry Pi imager is a great and new efficient way to image OSs onto your Raspberry Pi. It makes everything way more simpler and easy to use. Now plug in your SD card. Your SD card should have a drive label name. It should pop up when you plug it in. If it doesn't, that's okay, for sometimes it doesn't do that. Just look for it, then close out of that window. Now you need to choose an OS. You can pick Raspberry Pi OSs from here. There's many to choose from, but right now we're trying to get Octoprint, so you choose other specific purpose OS. OctoPi, which is an Octoprint distribution, which ships everything out of the box to save you the trouble of doing so. And then I click OctoPi, I choose my storage device, I have an external backup drive and an SD drive. Make sure you click the right drive. Mass storage device, I'll just click it again just to make sure. And then you write OctoPi to the thing. But before you're done, you might want to set up your Wi-Fi. Here, when you click Ctrl, Shift, and X, I'll put that up on the screen, you're able to change settings for your Raspberry Pi image. You can enable SSH, set a secure password, or you can do a public key authentication, and then you configure your Wi-Fi. You put your SSID, which is like and then like your password. Also, don't forget to input your country code, since for some places in the world, the Great Britain country code might cause some conflicts. You can also choose to add some persistent settings. Since I've already flashed this on an SD card, I just close out of there, but you would save and then you would write to your SD card. But now, let me transfer over to the OctoPi web interface. Here on the Octoprint web interface, you're able to see many analytics about your printer. Right now I've plugged in my Ender
Sorry, my Sovel SV01, which is a great starter printer. And right now I'm able to see how hot the bed is and the target temperatures. I can upload prints via dragging and dropping or by clicking the upload button. I can create folders. It tells me how much storage I have left. It gives me the state of the bed. Right now it's operational. I would also recommend for connection settings, you make it auto connect on server startup. It makes this process a lot more seamless. The only problem I've had is when my server starts and when I turn the off switch, I have to actually unplug the Pi for it to fully turn off. It seems like the Pi is providing power to the printer, but I can figure that out. Here, you're able to shut down the system, reboot the system, restart Octopi, or restart Octopi in safe mode for troubleshooting. Right here, you're able to see all your Octoprint settings, printer profiles, temperatures, G-code scripts, webcam and time-lapse. Right now, I'm using the Raspberry Pi Model 3A Plus, which is great since it has a cheaper price than a standard Pi 3 and also has more availability. But finalized, I can just see all target temperatures and many analytics about my Pi. Here you can see G-code, reselecting, terminal view. Right now I don't have any webcam, so you shouldn't be able to time lapse. But if you were to get a USB hub or to get the normal Pi 3 or 4, you would be able to plug in a webcam with the 3D printer. But this has been Octoprint. It's a pretty straightforward setup. You should be able to set it up in half an hour or less. Thank you for watching.